Welcome to the Coupler.io Academy, where industry experts share tips and tricks on working with data. In this video, we will teach you how to use the Sparkline function in Google Sheets. Hi, I'm Josh. Working with Google Sheets, you may have come across sparklines that are commonly used to visualize data. In particular, trends, changes over time, spikes and dips, and so on. While Google Sheets sparklines may not be as customizable as traditional charts, they have a particular advantage. They can fit into a single cell on your spreadsheet. Pretty cool, right? You can draw sparklines with the Sparkline Google Sheets function. Its first, and the only mandatory argument, is the data range to visualize. Commonly, it's a range of cells in a single row or a single column. However, Sparkline can also accept two rows or two columns, but no more. The second optional argument are options that allow you to customize a sparkline, wrapped in curly brackets. Options differ from one type of sparkline chart to another, and I'll discuss them as we go through this video. For this Google Sheets sparkline tutorial, I'll be working with a dataset of advertising metrics, with metrics split into months. If you want to follow along, then grab this spreadsheet from the video description below and let's get started. For the total traffic metric, I want to draw a sparkline to visualize how values change month to month. So, below the table, I'll type in sparkline and specify the range. This has drawn a simple line chart. As with any other function, I can now stretch this formula onto other cells to get a separate sparkline for each metric. It's clear that the default chart type for the Sparkline function is a line chart. Other options include a stacked bar chart, a column chart, and a win-loss chart. To use any of them, you'll need to specify the chart type option. I'll look into the paid traffic column now, modifying its Sparkline. After the data range, add a comma and open curly brackets. Then specify an option chart type and its value, both wrapped in quotes. Let's draw a column chart. Here you go. The same data is now shown in the form of vertical columns. A simplified variant of a column chart is called a win-loss chart. It's like a column chart, but all of the columns are of the same height. Let's test it out on the revenue column that features both positive and negative results. I'll type in the chart type option and specify win-loss. And here's the sparkline for this column. You can see that columns go upwards for positive values, while others go downwards when the value is negative. Last but not least, let's check the stacked bar chart. It uses two separate colors to compare between values. While it can take more than two values, I'd recommend sticking with exactly two values, as otherwise the chart will become rather unreadable. I loaded two more columns to my spreadsheet, detailing the revenues from Facebook and Google ads. So let's type in sparkline as usual and take two values to the left as the data range. The chart type will be bar. The sparkline now shows the split of revenues between both channels. I can stretch it down the column and it should give me a pretty good idea of a revenue split between both platforms. Okay, you now know the types of charts you can use with the sparkline function. The next step is to learn how to customize them to meet your needs. Perhaps you want to color some values, exclude results below or above a certain threshold, decide on the direction of charts, or how to handle missing values. You can do all of that and even more by choosing the right options for your Google Sheets sparklines. The dataset I've worked with so far had all the data I needed, and so was easy to visualize. Unfortunately, data analysis isn't always that pleasant. At times, you may have to work with datasets that lack values or have text inputs instead of desired values. Google Sheets Sparkline function will, by default, ignore both, but you can tell it to behave differently. I've already built a column and line charts for the first two metrics. For the column chart, I want to specify how to handle cells with non-numeric values, like the several no data inputs above. By default, they are ignored, meaning they are not included in charts, and that's why there are only four columns in a sparkline representing the four cells with values. I may want to include the empty cells in a chart after all. So let's copy the formula to the next row and add an empty option. Setting 0 there will tell Google to treat empty cells as zeros. Just like that. The non-numeric values are still ignored, and maybe they should stay that way. But perhaps I know that, in fact, no data means that there was no traffic at all in that month. I can include such values on a chart by using a NaN option and setting it to convert, which will convert such cells to zero. On the line chart, I'll show you one more option. By default, the data is shown from the beginning of the range till the end, here from January to December. But maybe I'd like to create a reverse Google Sheet sparkline. I can do this with the RTL option, which stands for right to left. Setting it to true will reverse the chart's direction. Note here that when values are of Boolean type or are numbers, you don't wrap them in quotes. All three options I've just shown could be used with different types of charts. For example, you can tell a line chart to ignore non-numeric values, but treat blanks as zeros. Or a win-loss, or any other chart, can have its direction reversed with RTL. There's a bunch of options, though, that can only be used with a particular type of chart. So how about we discuss each type once again? I'll show you how to customize each to your liking. Jumping back to my initial sheet, I have a few line charts that could use some tweaks. One thing you can do is specify the minimum and maximum value for each axis of a sparkline. Here, for example, I could set the y-axis to start only at 35,000. As a result, several results do not make it onto this chart. Likewise, with y-max, I can set the maximum value at, let's say, 70,000. You can also set the minimum and maximum values for the x-axis, but this will require some changes to the data range. If you select the cells from a single column or row as your data range, all your data will be on a single x-axis. This won't give you any space to manipulate that axis. However, Google Sheets Sparkline allows you to add a second row or column to the data range. When you do that, Sparkline will automatically treat the first column in the range as an x-axis and the second as the column with values to visualize. Likewise, if you create a horizontal sparkline with data encompassing two rows, the top row will be your x-axis, while the bottom one will contain the values for analysis. Sparkline formula in Google Sheets requires that an x-axis column or row contains only numerical values. For that very reason, I created a separate column with numbers of months, as the function wouldn't be able to process words like January, and I'll use it as my x-axis. Setting the new range doesn't change anything at first, because the value column didn't change. But now, you can take advantage of x-min and x-max options. For example, I think it would be a good idea to show a dedicated chart for the last quarter of the year, on top of the yearly view above. To do that, I can set x-min to 10, meaning that data will be shown from October onwards. Many options for this and other types of charts let you apply colors to sparkline charts. Here, I can type in color, wrapped, of course, in quotes. And let's color this line chart blue. Words like blue or red may be easier to use. But if you need a very specific color, or simply want to choose from literally millions of available colors, use hex codes instead. For example, to get the same blue, I could type in a hashtag, and then four zeros and the two Fs. Another customization you can do is a line width. Here, for example, I'll set it to 5, which will print a rather ugly, but at the same time, readable chart. Needless to say, you can also use the options I previously discussed with line charts, such as empty, NaN, and RTL. Okay, let's now talk about stacked bar charts, shall we? These charts are excellent for comparing values in two cells. Technically, you could add more than two cells to the data range, but the function uses only two colors to visualize the data. So I'd say two cells is just about the sweet spot. Have a look at the columns K and L in my dataset. Here I have revenues from ads split into campaigns running on Facebook and Google Ads. I've already set up sparklines for each row, specifying the chart type as bar. By default, the charts are stretched to the full width of each cell. This makes for an easy comparison, but doesn't tell me anything about the total revenue from both channels. Let's say the goal for each month is to earn $150,000 from Facebook and Google Ads combined. You can use the option Max to set the maximum value for each chart. Let's stretch it onto other cells. And now you have a sort of sparkline progress bars in Google Sheets. It's easy to tell that the June performance was far behind the goals, or that Facebook ads started picking up the pace come the second half of the year. The other two options let you specify the colors for the first and second value that are compared. Facebook is associated with blue, so let's pick this option for color one. And Google Ads, I'm not sure if they have one dominant color used across the interface, but they certainly have yellow somewhere in the logo. Okay, I'll use color two. Same as before, you can use hex codes as before. And now, onto the last two available charts, a column chart and a win-loss chart. Here, the customizations mostly rely on colors, and there's plenty to choose from. In the meantime, I set up a simple column chart. You can see that, by default, the positive values go up on the y-axis, and the negative ones go downwards. First things first, I can set up a default color for the whole chart. Let's make it green. There's more. Column charts let you apply specific colors to specific columns. Let's try it. The low color option will apply to the lowest value on the chart. Let's color it brown. Similarly, you could use high color to spotlight the highest value. The neg color option is about the negative values on the chart. I'll make them black. Let's also customize the last column on the chart with the last color option. As you may have guessed, you would use first color to address the first column of the chart. And here you go. You can see that the last column is indeed purple. Then the lowest value is brown, as expected. The data for July is black because it's negative, while everything else is green. There's a certain hierarchy of colors here. Although green was set as the color for a chart, columns are green only if no other option was applied to them. What's more, the lowest value here is brown, even though it's also a negative value. The low color option is higher in the hierarchy than the neg color option. Two other Google Sheets sparkline options revolve around axis. With an axis option, you specify whether an x-axis should be displayed. By default, it's not. And you can color it to your liking with axis color. And finally, you can manipulate the y-axis, same as I did before for the line chart. For example, I can set it to start from 10,000, which will eliminate all columns lower than that value. Not particularly useful nor pretty if you ask me, so let's revert. Okay, last but not least, the win-loss chart. It's a type of column chart and many of the options are the same. The only exceptions are the Y-min and Y-max settings, which wouldn't make sense here because columns on the win-loss chart have a fixed height. Let's look at an example. Say I want to differentiate positive values from negative. There's no option for positive values, but I use a sort of workaround. So I'll set the default color to green, and the negative values will be red. Here you go. To wrap up this Google Sheets Sparkline tutorial, I wanted to show you a few tricks and advanced uses for that function that may come in handy. First, let me show you how to combine several Sparkline functions. Here's a separate tab with the revenues for the four advertising channels. Below, I set up and customized sparklines for each channel. Now, I would like to create one more sparkline for all channels combined. Of course, I could just sum up all revenues in column G. Then I would use these results to draw a sparkline. But what if you don't want to clutter your spreadsheet with the additional calculations and simply want to see a combined sparkline? You can achieve it with a simple query function nested inside of Sparkline. Let's delete this data and type in query. As the data range parameter, select the column to serve as your x-axis and all the data you want to combine. Next, as a query itself, select B, so the column with month numbers, and then a sum of columns C, D, E, and F. If you'd like to brush up your knowledge about query, check out our tutorial that pops up in the corner of your screen. Query returns yet another summary for each month, but I don't want more summaries. Instead, I'll put query inside of Sparkline, and it will give me the same chart as I had before, just without all this additional data. Sparkline formulas can get lengthy and complex as you add more and more options. What's more, as you add a number of charts across your spreadsheet, keeping them visually consistent may prove challenging. Here's another trick that will make your life easier. Rather than type in options for each Sparkline individually, you can create a table with all the options and their values. It can reside in the same sheet or in a completely different sheet. I like to keep them together with other spreadsheet parameters like values for drop-down lists. Once you have the options ready, write a Sparkline as usual. Pick the range and now make the references to the options you want to use. So in my case, it will be pairs of I2, J2, I3, and J3, and so on. I'll save you some typing and let's see the result. Let's expand it for better visibility. Now, the beauty of this method is with the ease of modifying anything on the Sparklines. I simply need to change one value and the chart will immediately update. The same would happen to any other Sparklines linked to this field. And the same way, I can change the chart type. Note that the line chart doesn't have all the settings outlined here, such as low color or axis, but it's not a problem. They'll simply be ignored. And the last thing I want to share, same as I did with query before, you can combine Sparkline with many different functions. It could be simple things like sum or max functions, or something more advanced, like Google Finance function. Here, I have a simple spreadsheet with stock and their tickers. I've prepared a Google Finance formula that takes a ticker and returns a closing price for that stock, from 60 days ago up until today. Be sure to check out our Google Finance tutorial if you're curious about how it works. The raw data for the Apple stock would look like this. And same as before, let's put Sparkline around it. And here's the 60-day chart for that stock, and for the other stocks too. And that's it. Now you know how to create a Sparkline in Google Sheets. But if you have any questions, feel free to ask them down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, then please give us a like, share the video with others, and subscribe to the channel so you never miss a thing. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.